Slenderman's Army is a unique survival horror game written and developed by Hypno.net using RPG Maker VS Ace engine. Slenderman is back, but this time he has friends with him. So the overall story of the game is you are a paranormal investigator and you're investigating a house door. You find yourself attacked by a monster. So what I like about the game is the choice that you get at the beginning to be a male or female. But a few minor things are holding the game back. One is a confusing mapping. And what I mean by that is it has dead ends that is essentially game breaking. The second thing that holds the game back is the pages are randomized too much. So in the original Slender Man, the pages are put in a set location. And then each time you enter the play the game again, it resets and put it in a different location. But what this game does is every time you leave the map and enter the map again, the pages get reset. So that is not good. It's supposed to be in a set location for the whole game and then change after you start a new game. So another thing is Slender Man in this game really isn't scary, but there are some scary moments, but it could just be because I'm playing it because the sun is out and everything. But it could be scary. And the other thing is at the rate that he comes out is too frequently and has you running back and forth throughout the game. Now for the good things about the game. First of all, Slenderman's Army is fun. I mean, it has that scary element that is enough to scare you. And also, it does its job well to immerse you into the world. As you can see, it's very dark and it's very freaky. It's creepy because when Slenderman do catch you, the most pages I've ever found was 3. So, although the game has a confusing map, doesn't mean it doesn't have good mapping. Well, you can't actually really tell if it has good mapping or not because most of the map is invisible to you. But for what I've seen so far, the game's mapping is pretty good. So Slenderman isn't a game that has is not heavily reliant on story, but it's a kind of a game you pick up and then you play it for a few seconds just to see if you'll get scared or whatnot. So as for what it's trying to do, it's doing it well, but there are some things that could be improved, such as the AI. And another thing that's a downside to this game is that the world isn't big enough. The world isn't big enough. And as in this run, I got only 8 pages. Would I play again? Why not? The world isn't big enough for you to actually explore. It's mainly focused on you entering and re-entering the same map again to hope that the page randomly appears on that map once you're in it. So it's a good game to play for about 2 to 5 minutes, and then you get bored of it and then pick it up again later. But it's not something that you will play for hours. Maybe you can play it for hours. That's it for this first game showcase. I had a lot of trouble starting off this episode because I was having problems with my equipment. And when I say equipment, I just mean my software. It was acting up with my recording, so I had to do it in a different way. But hopefully next time I will make it more appealing, I will say. So thank you guys again for tuning into this first episode of game showcase, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I will end with this Slender Man's Army. Check it out. The link I will put down below so you can check it out yourself. Thanks again for watching. Make sure to comment this video, make sure to like this video, and for you guys who are not subscribing or just tuning in right now, make sure to subscribe for more game showcase as my other series that I'm doing right now. Peace.